It's our GoJacks.com weekly update with head football coach John Stiegelmeier, and we had discussed going into last Saturday's contest at Youngstown State. This would be a bit of a measuring stick for both your program and Bo Pelini's, and you'd have a little bit better idea of where you sit after the non-conference and the improvement week. Tell me about what you found out about your football team on Saturday.
Well, first of all, really disappointing performance, specifically our defense. You know, you can't judge yourself if you can't play all sides of the ball. And really, when the time of possession is 45 minutes for the other team, you need to rise up, you need to get off the field, and we weren't able to do that, so we have some work to do.
In that game against Youngstown, it's only one drive, but that opening drive of the game, you're going right down the field and turn it over inside the 10. I know it's just one possession, but that really sort of gave Youngstown some life and kind of got the ball rolling in a bad way.
Well, it did. Any turnover, wherever it's at on the field, is momentum. And when you turn it over going in to score, essentially, it's a huge momentum. And then they drive the field, which also, adds to that. So, but that was one play. There are a lot of positives there. We drove the field easily in that series, so we could have built on that.
And you alluded to the fact the first two drives of the game, you moved up and down the field pretty well. And then after that, in part because of the time of possession, just tough to gain a solid footing offensively.
Yeah, I think we panicked a little bit as a staff in all phases. You know, we started blitzing a little bit more and to stop their run instead of fit it up, do your job. And then I'm sure Coach Eisenhuth felt like every play had to count, had to be big because of the limited possessions.
Talking about your defense, you mentioned some of the positive things. There were a couple of drives that the Penguins had, both at the end of the second quarter and early in the third, where they get inside your 10-yard line and you don't allow them to score. Time runs out at the end of the second quarter, and then the pick by Lorenzo Williams in the third.
Yeah, our guys never quit. I mean, we maybe played some bad defense at times, maybe made some bad calls at times, but our guys' effort was tremendous. And case in point, keeping them out of the end zone when it looked like they were going to score. So really proud of that.
You and I talked about this after the game, too, but it's easy when things go well and everybody pats you on the back to have a positive vibe in the locker room. And those are the times, I think, as a coaching staff, you almost pinpoint some of the things to work on the most and try to level things out. Is this sort of the inverse here when you've struggled a little bit and lose a game like that to build them back up some?
Well, yeah, you don't want to tear away at your guys when they work so hard and they lose a hard-fought game. You know, you got to find some positives. You also have to be objective. You also have to look at the film and say, okay, this is what we need to do better if we have a chance, if we're going to have a chance to accomplish our goals.
To wrap up the discussion about Youngstown State on Saturday, what was your biggest takeaway from that conference opener?
Number one, they're a really good football team, and so are we. And we talk about it all the time. You got to play great defense if you're going to win a championship. We did not do that.
All right, let's look ahead to Saturday. Back at home against Southern Illinois. To be back in the stadium two straight weeks you'll be at home has to be music to your ears.
Well, one week at a time, but we're excited to be back. We're excited to be in front of our fans. They've been great so far. Expect them to be even better. And expecting a tough battle again. Southern Illinois is a good football team.
Let's talk about the Salukis. 2-2 on the year. They played a very challenging FBS game at Memphis and pushed the Tigers to the limit. And against Northern Iowa on Saturday to open up league play, certainly could have won that game. Had three drives inside the UNI 20 that came up empty at a 7-point loss. So this is a good football team coming into Brookings.
They're really good. They're really good on offense. They're really sound and pretty good on defense. Really impressed with their quarterback and their speed on offense. They're going to stretch you in the field.
Folks may remember last year you played a 45-39 game that took 4 hours in Carbondale a year ago, and it's a similar style. They're going to throw the ball 40 times a game. They want to spread things out. They can run it too, but, I mean, they're going to run a lot of plays offensively and do it fairly quickly.
They have a system, you know, and as we look at our last year's game and look at what they're doing now, they don't vary from that. They're going to be able to run power-type football, but they really want to spread you out, throw the bubble screens, throw the bubbles and go, you know, really isolate people in space.
And to give people an idea of how fast-paced they are and what they want to do with quick throws, they've thrown almost 40 times a game. They've been sacked one time in those first four games.
Yeah, I give credit to their O-line, but give credit to their quarterback. He is really sharp back there, knows where the receivers are, knows where the pressure's coming from, gets rid of the ball.
And again, defensively, they have played well this season. When you look at the numbers, what jumps out to you from the video side of things when you watch the Saluki defense?
I'm impressed with their athletic ability. You know, again, they're very sound, and so you can't find an advantage. You have to find ways that you just need to get 4 yards here and 8 yards there. You're not going to get the big hit against them.
And to wrap it up, it's Hall of Fame weekend. It's always a big weekend on campus as we celebrate a newest class into the Hall of Fame, including a young man who played for you at running back, Josh Ronick.
Yeah, what a neat honor for him to be inducted into the Athletic Hall of Fame, and just a great person, great football player, one of the best football players I've ever been around.